situation, like the plot, the politics, it just had so much. It was so just fully fleshed out and well written. American experience, but just kind of broadly. But of course, he's Vietnamese, so he does focus on that. Just because he has obviously his own personal experience, and he talks about like his parents and what they sacrificed to come here, and he talks about, you know, grappling with his parents. Is the such a big cliffhanger that I was just, this is definitely one of my most anticipated releases of 2024. And yeah, I just really love all the characters. Like, this is YA fantasy, so you know, it definitely has that like classic YA fantasy vibe to it, but I just loved it. It is not cheesy in any way. Like, in my opinion, like, the writing is not cheesy. It's not like overly angsty or anything like that. It's just very entertaining. Such a page turner. Okay, and then the last 5-star read I had, which relates to one of the other ones, is Children of Fallen Gods by Carissa Broadbent. This is book two. In the War of Lost Hearts trilogy. Yeah, I mean, obviously, loved this. Jumped into the third one after I finished this, which I don't do that a lot. Like, the last time I did that was with the Prison Healer trilogy, which was like in my top 10 favorite books of last year, so I feel like that's a sign when I just want to jump right into the next one, you know, given that the next one is out already. This series, it reminds me so much of like the later books in the Throne of Glass series, you know, like the last couple books in the Throne of Glass series. It has like the high tension, it has the high stakes, and yeah, this one had like a plot twist like in the second half of the book that I was not expecting at all. Covers, like, kind of, also like Throne of Glass, I feel like Throne of Glass had this kind of weird girl, and I don't like it. Education and Malice by S.D. Gibson, who is the author of A Diary of Blood. I'm telling you guys, it's not like I have, you know, like 50,000 followers or anything, but I still, you know, the publisher okayed me to read this one on NetGalley. So if you guys, I feel like anyone can get approved, you know what I mean? Like, you don't have to have a huge, huge following. So I would totally just make an account, you know, if you're interested, make an account and just like request the titles that you're interested in and see if they approve you or not. Like, I feel like I'm 50-50. Like, I've noticed that Berkeley Publishing, the ones that do like most of the big romance books like Emily Henry and stuff, they are pretty picky though. I think they really only approve people that have like a large following, but yeah, a lot of the publishers, they just kind of want to get the word out, so they'll probably approve you. So anyway, yeah. Yeah. you like that series, the Mysterious series, hopefully you guys know what I'm talking about. I think you'd really like this one as well. It's like, takes place in the UK. And yeah, I just, like, if I was a kid, like, I really enjoyed this. I gave this 3 stars, but I feel like I would have been obsessed with this one as a kid. Or, you know, as a middle schooler. Of like a, you know, they don't have a lot of money or anything like that. It's just the three of them working together. But I love all three of the characters, especially Lockwood. He's just like that boy, you know, like that kid that can like charm everyone, but he's like hiding a secret, which at the end of this first book, like, you still really don't know anything about his past. Suitable for pretty much all ages. And yeah, I'm reading the second one now concurrently with the other book I'm reading, which is The Atlas Paradox. Yep. And then I think this is the last book I read on Kindle, so let me pull that up real quick. This one I also got approved on NetGalley to read early, and that is Court of Wonders by Rin Chupeco. This is the second and final book. I don't know what the duology is called, but the first one was called Silver Under Nightfall. It's also a vampire story. I love that book. I can't remember if I gave it a 4 or a 5, but it was like pretty up there. So I was highly anticipating this one. And I was a bit disappointed. Like, obviously I did overall enjoy it, but I read this one right after I read Mother and Death of Dawn. And so like the dynamics between more books. This series is really, really popular on TikTok, and I don't know what compelled me to pick it up, but I did. I had zero expectations, guys. Like, my expectations were on the ground. I thought I was going to hate it so much, because for me, some books, especially kind of like TikTok popular books, that I just know aren't gonna work for me. So like, I don't know, the Icebreaker series that's popular, or the one with the cowboys, I forgot what it's called, or yeah. Just like, oh, that Spanish Love Deception, I read like 5 pages of that, and it was like the worst thing I read. So I really went into this like prepared to hate it. Tell me why. I was actually kind of pleasantly surprised. Let me trace the second one also. Like, okay, yeah, it's a bit predictable. If you're picking this up, you've kind of got to know it'll be predictable. Yeah, it just kind of wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be, and I was very entertained. And I will read the other two, like, because I want to know, like, how each couple ends up together, you know? So, the first one follows, like, a girl named... Sorry, guys. What's her name? Ava Chen. And she... It's like a friends to lovers. Actually, yeah. Friends, or is it enemies? Kind of enemies. But they're also friends. No. Okay, yeah, it's enemies to lovers. They're not friends. But he is her brother's best friend. And he has like a very, very dark, twisted, haunted past. And she's like your bubbly, you know, optimistic, cheerful girl. Okay. And then the second one follows Ava's friend and her bodyguard. And her friend is like a princess of this really small country, so think like Genovia in Princess Diaries. Like, her friend is a princess, and this is the story of her and her bodyguard. Okay, the third one, which I've not read yet, is about Ava's brother and Ava's best friend. So there's already been kind of like hints of their relationship. Theirs is also kind of enemies to lovers. But anyway, I'm just saying that they're actually not horrible, and I was invested, guys. I actually was invested. Okay, and then my last 2-star read was Vladimir by or anything like that, but I do remember people talking, like, this has been on my TBR for quite a while, and it is very, very well written, guys. Like, it's just, like, the author has the skills to write a good literary fiction novel, but other than it's like smart, it's sharp, that's it. The writing. insufferable, has no redeeming qualities. And you guys know, I feel like I say this a lot, I don't mind pretentious, unlikable characters if it, like, serves a purpose, like, either for the character's arc or development, or, like, a foil for a different character or something like that, you know? Like, why do I want to write a book where every single character sucks and has nothing redeemable? I also don't know, like, what the author's point was. So it's about, like, a woman, she's older, trying hard. I don't know if that makes sense, but someone is found dead, okay? And then you're trying to figure it out. I just really hate it. Okay, see, like, listen to this. Okay, this is a tale of murder. Or maybe that's not quite true. At its heart, it's a love story, isn't it? Chase, and I'm going to tell you a story unlike any you've ever heard. That's like, my name's Elliot Chase. I'm gonna tell you a story. That's how the whole book is written. Like, it's so annoying and it's not clever. Like,